When gas explosion occurred on the 4th of January 2020, it left in its wake destruction and loss of life. While many ascribed it to the regular cooking gas LPG, industry knowledge tells us it's not LPG, but acetylene and oxygen gases used mainly in the industries. Perhaps the increased proliferation of retail centers for LPG, liquefied petroleum gas, heightened such allusion. However, there's an increased concern and comment on the dangers that may have been associated with having these guys in co-locations with residents. The various incidences of the recent past has also prompted actions suggesting there'll be a clampdown on non-compliant outfits. So we went out to ask who is qualified to be in and who will be thrown out.
Government chasing them will not solve the problem. BPRC need to go through the normal procedure which they have. That a bigger plan like this, we should be championing or sponsoring the distributors.
According to the law,
because in the form they are going to fill to be a licensed trader of gas, it is expected that you must have a sponsor.
One thing is clear, regardless of what gas it is, where it is located, who operates it, who retails it, who distributes it, who even uses it, three rules apply: safety, safety, and safety.
Gas is very simple. I don't know. Once you follow the procedure of safety, you can even sleep here. One, there is no leakage, and if there is any leakage, it automatically triggers off itself. Very sensitive. It pulls off. And where we are loading from, they will never allow you to load a single, not 1 kg, without the shutdown system.
If anyone is in doubt, however, as to how intense the clampdown will be, just listen to the new helmsman at the agency.
The open sale of gas is banned. We reintroduce the Class D license, in which you will not be able to access gas more than home use. Do not buy any gas that do not have that Class D license.
To find out, they carry a lot of sharp practices. Once they are retailing, they will go to refilling plants and buy about 10 cylinders. They want to convert them to about 15 cylinders just to increase their profit margin. Sometimes, even the buyers want to give some money for top off. When you top off LPG cylinders, you know, you are just causing an explosion.
When the federal government removed subsidy from kerosene 4 years ago and put the estimate at $1 billion, it only gave credence to the rise in the use of cleaner fuel, LPG. While some argue its safety around residents, the industry thinks differently. And aside being clean, its use gives the federal government zero subsidy costs. A middle ground between proliferation and the attendant hazard is to practice safe handling.